It didn't take long from the moment Seiko launched the NH34 for the watch market to become saturated with affordable GMTs, which isn't a bad thing, it's a good thing, but it also didn't take long for the watch market to become flooded with dive style GMTs. Watches that look like dive watches don't necessarily have all the functionality, they're actually GMTs, but in that sort of dive style appearance. And yeah, I'm not a massive fan of those. If you're going to bring two watches together to make a sort of hybrid, the functionality has to be there for both styles of watch. And so when Areotec reached out to me and said, would you like to review the Ace X GMT diver? I thought, oh, not another sort of impractical hybrid. But no, they've actually created a proper functioning dive watch, and they've made it a GMT. What a relief. Just look at the crystal on this thing. How cool is that? It's the sort of crystal I would expect to see on a Kickstarter watch, something like Le Dome. I reviewed that watch recently. It's quite a sort of overemphasized double-domed piece of crystal. And that's not the only interesting thing about this watch. They've made a fairly uncompromising GMT diver, and that's the first thing I want to address. There's a very, very small elephant in the room sat in the corner over there. I've said quite a few times, I'm not a massive fan of watches that bring together two styles, and there's a lot of sort of GMT dive style watches these days. But what they've done here is they have created a dive watch. Okay, it's not an ISO 6425 certified diver, certainly don't think it is, but they've made a dive watch. It's got a dive bezel, it's got lots of water resistance, but they've also used the Seiko NH34 and added a second rotating bezel, which I think they have to be commended for. They've not gone into it in a sort of half-hearted way, which I've seen all too often recently. I've seen watches that look like dive watches, but they're actually GMTs and the manufacturers haven't really committed to it. Well, Areotec have committed to it. It is a diver GMT. And this over-pronounced piece of crystal isn't the only interesting feature on this watch. I mean, just look at the case back. It's got another two pieces of crystal in it. Okay, you don't get a great view of the NH34, but who cares? Because, well, it's the NH34. My only concern with those two pieces of crystal would be that, well, if you're selling this as a dive watch, you would want to limit the opportunities that water has to get into the case. And you've added with this case back two more seals that have to hold out when you're wearing this watch diving or just swimming. So I'm not completely convinced that was the best choice, but it's definitely different. In fact, the whole case back is pretty cool. Other features I like include the double-ended quick-release spring bars, the dial. Just look at that dial. And this sort of dial seems to be very popular at the moment. The sort of waves, sand dunes. I don't know what you would call that, but it's sort of a, again, an over-exaggerated sort of pitted textured dial. Cool fading dial as well. Darker at the bottom, a bit lighter at the top, and it's just got a really cool sort of cherry red look to it, hasn't it? This whole watch just pops with colour. Lume on both crowns, and it looks to be pretty good lume as well. And there's lots of lume on the face of the watch. I'll show you the lume degrading at the end of the video. I'll do my standard 5-minute lume degradation test. The hands as well, they're not your sort of typical hands for a dive watch. Okay, the GMT hand is fairly typical, but I like the fact that it reaches right out to the GMT bezel and it's nice and bright, it's orange. The legibility of this watch is impeded a little bit by, well, the dial, the crystal, and, well, all the hands. But it's not unreadable, it's just not that readable at a glance. The second hand sort of disappears a little bit. The silver hands just don't tend to contrast particularly well with the dial, because I think there's lots of shimmer and shine and reflection from the dial. But they've really gone all out, haven't they? And I think you'd want them too when you consider the price. Now, they've got this listed for $559. They've knocked $100 off, so it's $459. When I went on the website a few moments ago, just to double check all the specifications were correct, to the ones that I've got listed, that is, I got a pop-up saying 10% off. So you could potentially, I believe, get 10% more off of the $459, which drops the price to just over $400. I don't think that's an unreasonable price for this watch. I'll run through the rest of the specifications in a moment and show you the finishing, which seems to be pretty impressive. I think there's a lot going on. I think there's enough going on for them to justify the $400, slightly over $400 price tag, for sure. There is a Seiko NH34 in here. I'm pretty sure you guys are familiar with that movement, so I'll move on fairly swiftly. 316L stainless steel and two rotating bezels, a 120-click unidirectional bezel for the sort of dive watch element, and quite a bit of back play look. The clicks are nice and it lines up nicely, but there's just a bit of looseness to this bezel. It doesn't wobble, it feels attached to the case fairly firmly. It's just, yeah, when you basically put it where you want to put it, you sort of have to move it back a little bit to lock it into place. Let me show you. Oh no, see, I've got to go one more look. I've got to go past it and then move it back. So that sort of back play I wasn't expecting, actually. It's not a bad bezel action. It's not a massive flaw. It was just a bit of a surprise. But then, of course, there is another rotating bezel. You undo the crown at the 2 o'clock and it engages that internal bezel. There is some sort of ratcheting, a slight sort of clicking that you can feel through the crown. And it is possible to get the internal bezel to line up nicely, although it took me a few goes. Some internal rotating bezels like this have really, really nice actions, where as soon as you put the crown in, it disengages the bezel. It doesn't move at all. So lining it up at the 12 o'clock is really, really easy. I've struggled with this one a little bit. Let me just show you. If I line it up there, look, push the crown in, just give it a little bit of a wobble. I've managed to do it fairly quickly on this occasion. The last time I was trying, it took me a couple of goes to get the crown to properly disengage, so that when I wound it up, it didn't just move the bezel on ever so slightly. But yeah, it is possible, as you can see, to get it lined up nicely. Applied indices, lots of loom. You've got loom on that sort of cherry red aluminium bezel insert. Loom on the dial and the hands. The 24-hour internal rotating bezel doesn't have loom on it. Screw down crowns and a screw down case back. Only 200 meters of water resistance. And I say only because looking at the depth of this watch, I think you'd expect it to be 300 or 500 meters of water resistance. But it's quite a deep case, because you've got two rotating bezels and then you've got that accentuated or exaggerated piece of double domed crystals. So if you like your watches to sit fairly high on your wrist and be noticeable, you're going to love it. If you like your divers to be a little bit more petite and sit a little bit closer to your wrist, I think, like I do, I tend to prefer my divers to be a little bit less obvious. You're probably going to be put off by the depth. I'll put all the dimensions in the bottom right hand corner when I pop it on my wrist. Nice bracelet though, beautifully finished. In fact, all of the steel finishing is really, really nice. A slightly sort of polished coin edge to the outside of the rotating bezel, but I think everything else is polished apart from some of the details on the case back. The links are very, very nice. Lovely articulation, solid end links which fit nicely. They don't marry up to the case perfectly. It's not, I would say, disappointing. It's just the ends of the links look, don't seem to match the ends of the lugs perfectly. But yeah, it marries up well enough. All of these links, these five links, are individual. So you've got this good articulation. Split pins, no screw links. Little bit disappointed with that, but it's not a deal breaker. A pressed outer shell, it's not unexpected. Three micro adjusts, that's pretty good. And machined inner elements. Double pushes, safety latch, and a signature, of course. Now, I've studied the macro shots and macro footage that I've taken, and the steel finishing is very, very nice, as is the finishing on the dial and the applied indices and the hands. I haven't seen any dust, debris or DNA under the crystal or on the dial, so it's a nice, clean and beautifully assembled watch, seemingly anyway, from the pictures and the footage that I've seen. And I like the look of it, to be honest. I like the dial. There's a lot going on. I think they've crammed a lot into this watch, and you're sort of getting two watches for your money, aren't you? Of course, there are cheaper NH34 powered GMT watches out there, but I think you'll struggle to find a GMT dive watch with the NH34 inside it that packs as many interesting features and elements into it as this one does, because they really are offering quite a lot with this watch. And it is quite unique, it's quite original, so they have to be given a lot of credit for that as well. I'm impressed with my first Areotec. So how does a watch with dimensions like this feel on my roughly average sized wrist? It actually feels okay. It is a little bit top heavy. You notice the depth of that watch or the case and the crystal fairly quickly. It is obviously quite a tall watch. So really it's only going to appeal to people that like sort of chunky divers like this. But there's fairly decent weight distribution because you've got solid links and a solid sort of milled clasp. Of course, it's just feels a little bit top heavy on my wrist. Like I've said already, it's got some really cool features. It's definitely a little bit different. Would I part with just over $400 for this watch? Probably not, because as I've mentioned already, I do tend to prefer my divers to be your slightly smaller 200 meter divers. This watch was on Kickstarter and I believe it did pretty well, and I'm not at all surprised. There really are some very interesting elements and design features on this watch, and so it is nice to see something a little bit different.